Tapping into Blue Sun's communications. Stay tight and look out for ambushes. You got it. Here we go. Keep close. Shot in the back and left to rot. That's definitely Vito's style. Let's push ahead. Go into cover. Firing an impact shot. Concussive shot! After you.
Coming! Right. Gotcha.
You got it.
Thank you.
Chicago. If any of you retreat while the intruders are still alive, I'll kill you myself. Now get the hell back out there!
Vito. Sounds like he hasn't changed.
Sounds like he needs to get shot.
Glad to see you and I agree. I knew he was a sadistic bastard back when we started the Blue Suns. The Suns only got meaner after he staged his little coup 20 years ago. So yeah, we have a past.
Why didn't anyone tell me you founded the Blue Suns?
Because it's not common knowledge. Vito wiped me out of the records. He ran the books, I led the men. Worked real well for a while. Then Vito decided to start hiring Batarians. Cheaper labor, he said. Goddamn terrorists, I said.
20 years is a long time to hold a grudge.
A grudge? Vito turned my men against me. He paid 6 of them to restrain me while he put a gun to my head and pulled the trigger. For 20 years, I've seen that bastard every time I closed my eyes, every time I sighted down on a target, every time I heard a gunshot. Don't you call that a goddamn grudge?
You survived a gunshot to the head?
Yeah. And you survived your ship getting disintegrated. A stubborn enough person can survive just about anything. Rage is a hell of an anesthetic.
We'd better get moving.
They're at the southern axis. All squads mass at the gatehouse. Now!
They know we're here. Bring it on, you son of a bitch!
Zaid Masani, you finally tracked me down.
Vito.
Don't be stupid, Zaid. I have a whole company of bloodthirsty bastards behind me, ready to kill or be killed on my command. Actually, take your shot. Give my men a reason to put you down like the mad dog you are. Again. Gone nearsighted, old friend.
Burn, you son of a bitch.
You just signed your death warrant, Masani.
What the hell are you doing?
Opening the gate.
Next time you're gonna blow something up, I want to know about it first.
Vito was confident, had a lot of men. Now he's lost the home field advantage. If we keep up the pressure, no way he's getting out of here alive.
This isn't the time. We'll discuss this later.
Once Vito's dead, we can discuss anything you want.
On it.
We're trapped! We can't get to the gas valves to shut them off! The whole place is gonna blow!
No time. Vito's probably halfway to the shuttle docks by now.
You're willing to watch these people die?
Damn right I am. We stop to help these people and Vito gets away. And if he gets away, I'm blaming you.
Let's get moving before Vito gets away.
Glad you see it my way.
No! Help! No!
This might be useful.
I'll take it.
concussive shock!
Thank you.
Please. You know, it was nothing personal. Just business, I swear. It was 20 years ago. Look at you. I did you a favor. Zaid, please. I'm gonna die here, man. Do something.
Try, you son of a bitch.
How may I help you, Commander?
Is there anything I should know?
Nothing right now. Anything else, Commander?
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything. No messages for you, Commander.
Back for another lesson. Collectors and Protheans. It's all about my pay grade. I'm more used to putting down rebellions, tracking down bastards who didn't pay their gambling debts. Still, even I know a galaxy-shaking revelation when I hear one. Makes fighting land wars for pay seem small time. I've done a lot of crazy things, but I never tried to take on a Thresher Maw on foot before. Standard operating procedure when you get a Thresher Maw is run the hell away. Pick up sticks. Move the hell out. Krogan don't know any better, I guess. Still, hell of a fight.
Something.
Have a few minutes to talk?
Very well. I had been recording a message for Kolyat.
How are things going with him?
It is difficult. All things worth keeping are. I never explained. I suppose the story of my wife's death took you by surprise.
I figured you'd explain to me when you were ready.
I appreciate your patience. I kept my work clear of our home life. I assumed that would be enough to protect Erica. Memory I mentioned before. Laser dot terminals on the target's skull. The smell of spice on the spring wind. Sunset eyes defiant in the scope. That was Erica. That was how I met her. She saw my targeting laser as she walked by and threw herself in the way.
So how did she go from blocking your shot to having your children?
I had to meet her. The memory possessed and endowed me. I fell on my knees before her. Begged her pardon. She introduced me to the world beyond my work. Eventually, she forgave me. Later, she loved me.
I guess she impressed you.
She woke me up. Her body trembles. Not fear. Indignation. Her mouth moves. How dare you? You and I trained to sacrifice ourselves to save others. How often does a civilian step in the way of a bullet to protect someone they've never met? I thought she was the goddess Urashu. She met my eyes through the scope, and my purpose faltered.
When you talked to Kolyat, you said she died.
I let myself become complacent. I thought Erica and Kolyat were safe. I stayed away too long, and my enemies came for her.
Who came for her?
Batarians, a slaver ring that was preying on Hanar outer colonies. I'd killed their leaders. They paid the Shadow Broker to find out who I was, but they were afraid of me. So they went after her.
You're a smart man, Thane. You didn't take precautions?
I did. I should have done more. I knew my family was vulnerable. I accepted my death when I was 12. Nothing could make me accept theirs. My body hunted her killers, murdered them. I was taught to grant death quickly, cleanly, to minimize suffering. Them. I let them linger.
You were operating on instinct. By your own rules, you can't blame yourself.
But I made the choice to hunt them. They're the only lives I've ever taken of my own choice. The only deaths on my own conscience. I haven't spoken about my wife and I don't think I ever have. I didn't have anyone left to tell it to.
Thane, the worst thing is to face death with regrets. You're part of my crew, and I consider you a friend. If there's anything I can help you with, just ask.
I've never been part of a team. Assassins tend to be solitary. I'm learning the virtues of facing death with others at your side. It's a work in progress. Do you need something?
Have a few minutes to talk?
Later. I'd like to consider what we've already discussed.
You mind if I ask you a few questions?
Not at all.
I should go.
I shall return to my meditations.
There you are. Zaid strolling around like he owned the place. But he seems a little confused. 20 years of seeking revenge, and now it's over. The Normandy runs so quietly. I'm not used to hearing my footsteps when I walk. One of the girls in navigation thinks she might be pregnant. Even aboard a Cerberus vessel, life finds a way. Come back later. I'm sure I'll have more to talk about.
Commander, what can I do for you?
You have a minute, Miranda?
There's a lot to do, Shepard. Maybe another time.
I'll let you work.
Of course, Commander.
Shepard, need me for something?
Have you got a minute?
Can it wait for a bit? I'm in the middle of some calibrations.
Talk to you later, Garrus.
I'll be here if you need me.
Access to the AI core is restricted.